Hello friends, today we will see how to schedule activities in Odoo 15 CRM. So throughout the CRM operations, Odoo will allow you to plan and schedule different types of activities with customers. So you can easily create and configure various activities in different views of the module. So here we have the opportunity pipeline in a Kanban view, and you can view different opportunities in each stage, in different stages. So we can move them from one stage to another stage. And finally, if you want the opportunity, you can place it in one stage. So when you create an opportunity, or if you create a lead, you can follow up the customers using activities. So the activities can be sending a mail to the customer, or making a phone call, or scheduling a meeting. So that can be done from different views in CRM module. Like from the Kanban view, you can see for the opportunity, you can click on this widget to schedule an activity. So here you can choose activity type. Like in Odoo, we have different activities like email, call, meeting, make quotation, then to do, upload document. So you can choose one, and then you can provide a short summary of the activity that you are planning. Then here you can set the due date of this activity, then you can assign to user, and after that you can save the activity, or you can open a calendar and schedule the activity in a different date and time. So when you save it, you can see one activity is planned, which is due in 8 days, and you also have an option to edit the activity. So if you want to change it, you can click on edit and then save it. So I have extended this activity for 1 day. So like this way, you can schedule multiple activities for an opportunity. Like if you want to plan a meeting, you can open a calendar and then you can choose a time, you can choose a date and time, and you can create a meeting. So here we can click on that and edit. You can see a form where we can add the meeting details, like the starting date, ending date and time, then duration of the meeting. So by default it is 30 minutes, so you can change it. And if you want to plan this for every day, you can enable this checkbox, and you can choose organizer of the meeting. Then you can set reminders. Reminders can be email or notification some time before the meeting. And you can add the location of the meeting. Meeting URL can be provided here, and you can add tags. Then you can see some other options, like you can set the privacy of the meeting, like you can make it private, or you can make it public or available for internal users. And then you can also send invitations to the attendees of the meeting. So here you can see we have only added Michelle Admin as an attendee. Then here you can add more attendees and can directly send email or SMS from here. So after that, you can provide description for the meeting and save the meeting. So this is how we schedule a meeting. So this is one as a calendar view, and you can also view the list view of the meetings. So for this, we have scheduled a meeting for today. And if any of the activities is done, you can simply click on this mark as done, and you can provide the feedback of the activity and click on done. Or if you want to schedule a next activity, you can click on this button. Here you can schedule a new activity, or else you can discard it. So one activity is done. And you can also see for each stage, there is a color indication. So this is used to track the plan activities under the stage. So here we can see there is one activity for today and there is one overdue activity. So when you click on that, you can track that overdue activity. So it is planned for this opportunity, 5 VP chairs. And when you click on that, you can see it is 8 days overdue. And you can see we have one activity scheduled for today. And if there's a planned activity, that will be indicated in green color. So looking at the color, you can easily identify the status of activities in your stage. So this is how we plan activity from Kanban view. And we can also plan activities from list view. Like here you can see the field next activity. We can plan activity from here. Then we can find calendar view. And then when you open an opportunity, here, when you come under the section, you can find option to schedule activity. So you can simply click on this and again, you can plan activity. So here we can view all the plan activities for this opportunity. And from here, we can mark as done or we can cancel the plan activities. And there is also an option to view information related to planned activity. Like if you click on this, you can view the activity type, created date, can view the organizer and the due date of the planned activity. Then if you want to create your own activity, that is custom activity, then here, just come under configuration, you can find activity type. So these are some of the existing activity type and you can create a new one from here. Like you can provide the name and you can set the action that need to be done. So you can see we can open a meeting or we can make a phone call. Or you can view a tax report. Then you can set default user for this activity type and default summary. Then you can provide an icon, then decoration type. And you can plan, that is, you can suggest a new activity after this activity type. So you can either suggest or trigger a new activity. So if you trigger next activity, then here you have to provide the next activity that need to be triggered after the activity. Like if you want to send email, you can choose that. And you also have an option to schedule activity for this activity type. So it allows you to plan the action deadline. Like it can be, you can schedule activities 1 day or weekly or monthly after the activity deadline or after the completion date. So here I have set 1 days after previous activity deadline. Then after providing a default node for the activity type, you can save it. You can see that I have created an activity type discussion, which is planned 1 days after previous activity deadline. Now, if you try to create schedule an activity, you'll be able to choose the activity type that we have just created. So you can see we have planned one. So you can see with Odoo, it is so simple to create activities. And if you have any doubts regarding this video, you can add your comments below and do subscribe our channel to get latest updates.